In Lusaka, Lower Lusaka Upper and behind Albert Senior Secondary School in Mukati area, human activities are impacting the environment. People are constructing residential and business structures while others are growing sugarcane, spraying grass using herbicides and dumping rubbish in the buffer zone. Dickens Amanya, the coordinator of Bunyoro Albertine Petroleum Network on Environmental Conservation, says the impact of the established government institutions charged with environmental protection is hardly felt on ground.
This stream comes from what we call Mukati area, but it is more of a washing bay, and the whole of Hoima City is surrounded by the small rivers which have turned to be washing bays. However, for us environmentalists or social scientists, we look at the effect which these washing bays have on the population. One, they increase silting.
Authorities are worried if no steps are taken by the city authorities to conserve Bigajuka Swamp and other water catchment areas. River Wambambia, that hosts Kabalega Mini Hydro Power Dam on the shores of Lake Albert, could dry up.
This river connects with other tributaries and form into what we call Wambavia River, where we get ultimately electricity at Wambavia Seruka Dam. So any effect which is at the source of Wambavia has now an effect on the electricity which we consume. Then as city authorities, as we move on as an independent administrative unit, it's high time that we sensitize the public.
Eucalyptus trees are planted along water streams here. Those concerned have no power to act against environmental degradation. The Hoima City leadership has stepped up and are warning that people who will be found dumping rubbish in the wetland will be punished.
Bigajuka wetland is demarcated by NEMA. We demarcated that wetland, and the plans that we have as of now is now to enforce the people who have encroached on the wetland, make sure that they evacuate the wetland, and also to do some silting on the wetland so that the water continues flowing well. And then we are also drawing strategies on how we can address the people who do dumping of garbage, especially at night.
The Ministry of Environment statistics show that Uganda has lost more than 30% of wetlands in the last 23 years. This trend indicates the country's increased risk and vulnerability to natural disasters and other effects of climate change. Section 36 of the National Environment Act provides for the protection of wetlands and prohibits reclamation, erection of illegal structures, and empowers authorities to demolish any structure that is fixed in, on, under, or above any wetland. This report was compiled by Ambrose Niwagaba for the news.